In this Dynamo for Civil 3D example, we will place a guardrail along the edge of a highway corridor. This highway corridor is divided up into multiple regions, and we only want to have guardrail along the areas where we have retaining wall. There are a number of bridges along this corridor as well, and we don't need to install any guardrail along those as well because they already have barrier. We have a few gaps because of ramp transitions as well, and so we'll take a look at how we're going to do this in our Dynamo script. In the script that we've already established, we'll take a look at each of the nodes and how they interact. First, we're going to start with our current document, and the corridor we want to use in this case is our eastbound corridor. We do also want to take note of the baseline that we have used to generate that corridor, and we've got that as a code block in our baseline by name as well. One other area that we'll want to pay particular attention to is our feature line, and we have created a feature code right there called guardrail right. In our corridor, we have three different assemblies that we're utilizing. We have a bridge subassembly, as well as a subassembly for the ramp transition. But where we're going to place barriers is on the right side of our wall assembly. And we have created a point called guardrail right that we're going to utilize to place our barrier posts. And we've just done that with a mark point. We select mark point and we select the specific point that we want to create. And this is how we're able to identify this by region. This feature only exists in these regions. It doesn't exist on the ramp transition as we can see here, where we just have the EPS code. So we'll make note of that particular point that we'll use in our assembly and use in our script as well. And we'll identify the start and end stations for each one of those feature lines that are created. And we're using a code block here to identify our start and end station. For our step command, this is where we'll determine the spacing between each post. We'll use a slider command here. We'll just use an integer slider there. With this, we have the ability to determine the spacing, and we'll use 20 there. So that will set our stationing and our coordinate system. Next, we're ready to start placing our barrier. The barrier that we're going to be using is a post that we've identified as a block. We want to be able to rotate that 180 degrees so that it's facing in the correct direction. And here we've identified the name of the block that we're going to use for our post, as well as where that's going to be placed. That's going to be placed along our feature line. That's our origin. And our rotation is going to be about our z-axis. And so we're using that as our coordinate for our normal, since it's being placed in plan view. Now for the rotation, we need to use a series of vectors for the x and y values, and we're going to use a little bit of trigonometry here. We're going to use a function that's taking the arctangent of the opposite and the adjacent angles, or the x and the y's, and it's going to add 180 degrees to that angle. And this is going to orient our objects that we place in the correct manner along those feature lines. Our layer is going to be set as whatever we want to create it as, and we're placing these in model space. Once we're ready for that, we're ready to run the initial command just to look and see how our posts have been placed. And as we look in and view each one of these, we can see that they're in the correct position and in the correct rotation as well. The next step that we want to do is to create the face of our guardrail. We have our insertion point as well as our existing ground, and our posts are 3 feet above that existing point. So this is going to help us with the coordinates for creating this W shape for the face of our barrier, and it's going to be 0.2 feet out. We're going to create a point at each one of these inflection points on the W beam, and we're going to extrude that so that it is parallel to our profile. We'll do this using a code block. For this particular command, we're going to use points by coordinates, and we're going to set up a point by coordinate for each of those points, and we'll set up 5 points. We'll provide a coordinate relative to that insertion point. So our first point, we're going to specify x as a variable, but we're going to go 0 feet in the y direction and 3 feet up in the z direction. The next point will come down and we'll go out just a bit. And we'll repeat this process until we've created our 5 points to create that W beam shape. We'll copy that for the next code. And we'll modify that to 2.5. Next point will be our D value. And we'll add that coming out 0.2 feet and down at 2.25. And our last point we'll call at 2 feet down, we'll call that our E point. Now this would be the shape of a barrier on the left. So we'll call this W beam L for left. And this is going to be a polycurve. This is going to follow the feature line and the profile exactly. And we'll use that by points. We'll use points A, B, C, and D, and E. But this would be for the left side. If we're going to create one for the right side, we'll create our W right, and we'll just mirror our left side shape. We'll mirror that about the YZ plane. And in the condition where we would want to create both faces, we'll create that as W both, and we'll utilize both the left and the right shapes that we have just created. Now this provides a number of outputs that we can use. Our X value is just going to be the width of our block or our post. In this case, that's about 0.9 feet, and we'll provide that as our X value. Now once we have that, we're just going to use the right side as our output. And we want to utilize a geometry transform node at this point in order to provide the correct orientation and location for this barrier. Our coordinate system will again come from the same coordinate system that we're using to extract our feature line. And so we'll connect those points here as well. The next step that we want to take is to create a surface from those points that we just created. And we'll do that by selecting surface by loft. And again, that is going to create that surface parallel to our profile and to our feature line. Now the next step, we want to create a solid out of that, and so we want to actually create a thickness to that surface. So we'll connect that there. We can provide a code block to give the value of the thickness or the gauge size, and that's a good example right there. We have a syntax error because I haven't provided a zero before that. The code blocks will generally warn us, and so here I want it 0.01, and that's going to be the thickness of that gauge face. So Dynamo will tell us oftentimes when we have warnings or issues like that. The next step is to create the actual object itself, and we'll do that by geometry here. So the bottom node here, our geometry comes from our solid. Our layer we can specify as whatever we care to, and in this case we'll call this guardrail face. And that just has a code block. We'll connect that. Again, our block comes from our model space block that we had with placing the posts as well. So we're ready to run the command and view the output of our script. Once again, we can see that this is an effective way that we can create solids and objects along a corridor. We can break those up by feature line and by region.